Hello everybody, I'm Dr. Patil Sukil Kumar, AS, Professor and Head Civil Engineering Department, Valchi Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today I'm going to discuss about stability analysis of cantilever retaining wall with an example. Learning outcomes. At the end of this session, the students will be able to determine the depth of foundation for cantilever retaining wall. They are able to decide the preliminary dimensions of cantilever retaining wall. They are also able to carry out stability analysis of cantilever retaining wall. Example. Carry out stability analysis of cantilever retaining wall to retain an earth embankment with horizontal top 3.5 meter above the ground level for following parameters. Density of earth 18 kN per cubic meter. Angle of internal friction 30 degrees. SBC of soil 200 kN per meter square. Coefficient of friction between the soil and concrete 0.5. Stability analysis. H2 is the height of ground or height of earth fill, which is 3.5 meter given. The density of soil gamma s is given as 18 kN per cubic meter. The angle of internal friction is given as 30 degree. SBC, or we also call it as Q0, it is 200 kN per cubic meter square, and mu is 0.5. So first of all, find out the coefficient of active earth pressure, which is Ka, which is given by 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. So that works out to be 1 by 3. Can you please answer the questions? How to determine depth of foundation for cantilever retaining wall? And how to decide preliminary dimensions of cantilever retaining wall, which we have already discussed in last session. The minimum depth of foundation is given by d minimum equal to q naught divided by gamma s into k square, so which works out to be 1.23 meter. Let us provide a depth of foundation as 1.25. The height of retaining wall, which is equal to height of earth fill plus the minimum depth of foundation required 1.25 meter, that is 4.75 meter, it is total height, H, capital H we take. The preliminary dimensions of retaining wall are decided as per the guidelines. Width of baseline is taken B equal to 0.48H to 0.56H. So it was sought between 2.375 to 2.66. So let us provide 2.5 meter. Toe projection is 1/3 of B, or 0.3 times B. It is 0.75 meter. Thickness of base slab equal to the thickness of stem, that is given by H divided by 12. So that works out to be 0.4 meter. Let us provide a top width of stem as 0.2 meter. Figure 1 shows the retaining wall selected. That means here I have selected the top width 0.2 meter, bottom width 0.4 meter for stem slab, and for base width I have taken 2.5 meter. So toe projection is 0.3 times B, it is 0.75 meter, and this is 0.4 is width of thickness of stem at base. And 1.35 is heel slab length, and the thickness of base slab is taken again as 0.4. And the figure 2 shows the various forces acting on retaining wall. So W1, it is weight of soil. W2 is the weight of the rectangular portion of stem slab. W3 is weight of triangular portion of stem slab. And W4 is the weight of entire base slab. All these are acting at their CG locations. So X1 will be the distance from O to W1, line of action of W1. X2 will be the distance from O to line of action of W2. X3 will be distance from O to the line of action of W3. Similarly, x4 will be the distance of the from point O to the line of action of W4. So these are the distances from point O which we require for calculating overturning moment. And we are having PH, that is the destabilizing force. So W1, W2, W3, W4, they are stabilizing forces. And PH is a destabilizing force which is due to the pressure, earth pressure. So PH, it is given by half K into gamma H square. So PH will be the horizontal force which is acting at a distance H by 3 from the base. Check for stability. Various vertical loads W1, W2, W3, W4 acting on retaining wall, their perpendicular distances are x1, x2, x3, x4, just I have explained you on the figure. From overturning point O and the moment of these forces about O are shown in the table next to this particular, in the, on the next slide. So here you find, I have taken first weight of backfill. It is 1.35 meter length. Then we are having a height of 4.35 meter. Then this is density 18 kilonewton per kilometer. This gives you the total weight 105.7. And its distance from point O, its total 2.5 is the total base width minus 1.35 by 2. That is 1.835 is the distance of W1 from point O, and the, it causes a moment which is W1 into this distance, that will give us 192.9 kN. Similarly, for rectangular portion, it is 0.2 width and the height is 4.35, density of concrete is 25 kN/m³. So it gives us a weight of 21.75 kN, and its distance from point O is 0.75, this is toe slab, plus 0.4, that is thickness of stem slab, minus 0.1, that will come to the CG of that particular rectangular portion, that works out to be 0.88. So the multiplication of W2 and X2, that will give us 22.84 kN pending one. Similarly, for triangular portion of stem, W3, its weight, it is area into density. Area is 1/2, 0.2 into 4.35, that is height. So 25 is density, and this gives us a weight of 10.88 kN. And the, its distance from point O is 0.75 plus 2/3 of the base distance, that is 0.2, that is 0.88 meter. So the multiplication of W3 and 0.88, that gives us the 9.61 kN moment. Lastly, the base slab W4, 0.4 is the thickness, 2.5 meter is the width, and 25 is density. It is 25 kN, and it is acting at a distance of 2.5 by 2 from point O. So the multiplication of W4 and X4, that gives us 31.25 kN. So the sum of all these vertical loads, that is sigma W, it is 163.33, and the sum of all these moments, these are stabilizing moments, it is 256.6 kN. The horizontal pH, force pH is given by half K into gamma H square. So here half K is 1/3. It is 18 kN/m³. This is 4.75 square. This gives us 67.688 kN. The overturning moment M0 is equal to pH into H by 3. H by 3 is the distance of pH from, perpendicular distance of pH from point O. So that gives us a moment of 107.17 kN. As per IS 456-2000, factor of safety for overturning is given by FSO. It is 0.9 times sigma stabilizing, sum of stabilizing moment divided by the overturning moment. This is 0.9256.6 divided by 107.17. So that is 2.15, which is greater than 1.4, hence it is safe. So factor of safety for sliding FAS, so that will give, is given by 0.9 times mu into the sigma W, that is the weight of all vertical loads acting downwards, divided by pH. So therefore it is 0.9.5 into 163.33 divided by 67.688, which is 1.09, which is less than 1.4. So since this is less than 1.4, it is unsafe for sliding. Hence, shear key is to be provided. So the shear key is provided. So here we are supposed to have a projection here below the stem. You can provide shear key here, a rectangular shear key here, or you may even provide shear key here at the end. So that projection will offer resistance for sliding. So therefore, this is necessary to provide a shear key either here or here. So next, there will be an assignment. Carry out the stability analysis of cantilever retaining wall to retain an earth embankment with horizontal top 4 meter above the ground level for following parameters, that is density of soil 18 kN per cubic meter, angle of intersection 30, SBC 250 kN per meter square, coefficient of friction between soil and concrete 0.5. These are all the references used for preparing this particular talk. Thank you one and all.